In this video, we're going to go over power, ammeters, and voltmeters. Power, we've discussed before with work and energy. One measure of power is the rate at which work is done. When we're looking at circuits, power can also be defined as the rate at which electrical energy is transferred. This can either be looking at the battery, the rate at which the battery is delivering power to the circuit, or it can also be looking at resistors, the rate at which the resistor is dissipating electrical energy. And this would, for instance, be to power a light bulb or some other electrical device. The power can be calculated as the product of current and voltage, P equals IV. And since it's power, the unit is the watt. Now, sometimes you might see other equations for power, but it's really just applying Ohm's law. So remember, Ohm's law is simply V equals IR. So if you wanted to, in this equation for P equals IV, you can plug in V for IR, and then you would get another equation for power, which is power is equal to I squared R. If you want, you can also rearrange and solve for current. Current is voltage over resistance. If you plug that in for current, then you get another equation, which is power is equal to the voltage squared over the resistance. So this is technically two additional equations for power, but it's really nothing new because it's just combining Ohm's law with power. But essentially, just know that whatever values they give you, if they give you voltage and resistance, you can still calculate the power. Or if they give you current and voltage, you know how to calculate the power. Okay, so next I want to talk about meters. So meters are devices that are used to measure different values within a circuit. So ammeters are used to measure the current, voltmeters are used to measure the voltage. And you just need to know how to use these devices and also know the resistances of these devices. So first of all, in order to measure current, we know that current is the same in series, which is why an ammeter should be connected in series to the circuit element for which you want to measure the current for. In addition, you want your ammeter to have the lowest possible resistance. And that's because when you add in one of these meters, you want them to have the smallest possible impact on the circuit. And you know that if you connect circuit elements in series, their resistances add. And in order for the ammeter's effect to be as small as possible, you want it to have a very, very small resistance. So the total resistance is essentially unchanged, just the original resistance. Okay. Voltmeters are used to measure the voltage. Since we know that voltage is the same in parallel, we want to connect our voltmeter in parallel to the circuit element for whose voltage we want to measure. Now, when you have circuit elements in parallel, current has two different paths that it can flow through. Again, since we want the meter that we're using to affect the circuit as little as possible, we would want all of the current to pass through the resistor and not to pass through the voltmeter. The way you can do that is if your voltmeter has extremely high resistance. If it has extremely high resistance, then all of the current will just go through the circuit element for whose current you're trying to measure. So that's voltmeters. Connect in parallel, and you want them to have high resistance.